Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Ilhamis bin Muhammad Izzam.
And my name is Dini Ivan bin Mat Imran.
Okay, for today we want to present about our mini project for power electronic. And our title is Analysis of DC-DC Boost Converter Circuit. And now we look at for the first one, which is problem statement. In this problem statement, there are three points. The first one is we want to explain the significance of using gate driver for converter circuit. Second is we want to know how the principle of boost DC-DC converter circuit operation. And the last one, we want to analyze the boost DC-DC converter performance under variation of parameter. And our problem statement is also our objective on this mini project. And now, second is discussion of circuit operation and analysis. There are two points in this discussion. First one is when the switch is closed, second one, when the switch is open. Okay, when we look at for when the switch is closed, first, the current will flow through the inductor in the clockwise direction. Second, the inductor will store some energy by generating a magnetic field. Third, polarity will be positive on the left side. So, meaning is the inductor are now positive. Okay, when the switch is open, the current will be reduced as the impedance is higher. Second, the magnetic field will be reduced in energy to maintain the current towards the load. Polarity will be reversed, meaning the right now our inductor on the left side are negative. And last one, as a result, two source will be in series, causing a higher voltage to charge the capacitor through the diode. Okay, for analysis. The circuit is operated in the steady state. The inductor current is continuous and always positive. Third, the capacitor is very large and the output is held constant at voltage Vout. Fourth, the switching period is T and the switch is closed for time dt and open for time 1 minus d dt. D is our duty cycle. And the last one, the components are ideal. Okay, now we look at for result.
Okay. First, this mini project, we use the MATLAB simulation software. And it is the circuit. For the component we use, first we use the DC voltage and the value is 50 volt. And next, we use the inductors. And we put the current measurement and scope. Next, we use the MOSFET and we put the pulse generator. And the value for the pulse generator first output period is 0.81 divided for 40k. And we use the duty circle. We choose the 0.7. And next, we put the diode and capacitor. For the value capacitor is 0.001. Resistor, the value is 50 ohm. At resistor, we put the voltage measurement and we put the scope and display. For the display, we use to know voltage output. After finish, to the circuit, we simulate for the two second, and we can get waveform. So we get the two wave. First, we get voltage output and current inductor. This is the waveform. So table we on the waveform we get the output voltage. The value is 163.7 volt. Next current inductor we get level and for the output voltage ripple we get 0.5892. For the current inductor maximum we get 12.20 ampere and the last current inductor minimum we get 10.06 ampere.
Okay, now we look at for calculation. Okay, for calculation, we assume that we use our frequency is 40 kHz and duty cycle is 0.7. Okay, for VE, resistor, capacitor and inductor. Okay, this value be given to us in this mini project on the report. Okay, now we look at first, we find the Vout. Okay, Vout, we use this formula, which is Vin, divide by 1 minus D, and we get our value for Vout is 166.67. Good. And now we look at our current through the inductor, which is IL. Okay, the formula that we use, which is Vin divided by 1 minus D, the power of 2, and times by R. Okay, and we get 11.11 ampere. Okay, for current through the inductor, in minimum. Okay, the formula we get the current through inductor IL minus by the IL divided by 2L. And we get the value of IL minimum, which is 10.02 ampere. And for maximum, we use this formula. This formula are not the same one as minimum, which is minimum we minus, and for maximum they are plus. So we get the value, which is 12.20 ampere for IL maximum. And now for our voltage ripple, the formula that we use is D divided by RCF. And we get 3.5 times 10 power of negative 3, okay, or 0.35%. And for Iout, we use Ohm's law, which is we use Vout divided by R, and we get for Iout is 3.33 ampere. And now we back to our voltage output ripple. The formula that we use is D DVO divided by RCF, and that D over by RCF that we have get from the above equation, which is 3.5 times 10 minus negative 3, and we just times VO, which is 166.67, and we get for our voltage output ripple is 0.5833. Okay, they are a bit. Not a bit, there are a little difference between the major value. It's because a major value, maybe there are some component that we use have an error. That's why the major value and the calculation value are not the same one, they are different. And now for the last part for our presentation, which is conclusion.
Okay, this mini project conclusion. There are many things that we learn from this mini project, which is we came to explain the significance of using gate driver for converter circuit. So we also can understand the principal operation of both DC-DC converter circuit and analyze the both DC-DC converter performance under variations of parameters. So, objective accepted. Other than that, these many projects are improve more for our understanding about power electronics, and it also improve us on how to do the circuit on MATLAB software to get the best result. So, lastly, our mini project run smoothly and successfully. That's all for me. Thank you.
That's all for us. Thank you.
Thank you.